Good morning and welcome to Mission Control Houston and the International Space Station update. On board the International Space Station, the Expedition 30 crew has been awake since midnight Central Time, and they are now more than halfway through their day. U.S. Commander Dan Burbank and U.S. Flight Engineer Don Pettit, as well as European Flight Engineer Andrei Kuipers, and Russian Flight Engineers Oleg Kononenko, Anton Shkaplerov, and Anatoly Ivanishin are currently orbiting 259 miles above the South Pacific Ocean, heading towards Central America. Burbank, Shkaplerov, and Ivanishin launched to the station in their Russian Soyuz TMA-22 vehicle on November 13th and docked to the space station on November 15th, so they're working on their 107th day in space and their 105th day at the space station. Kononenko, Kuipers, and Pettit followed them into space in their Soyuz TMA-03M on December 21st and arrived at the station on December 23rd, so they're working on their 70th day in space and their 68th at the station. Both halves of the crew still have a good time left in their stay. Burbank, Shkaplerov, and Ivanishin are scheduled to leave in April, and the others won't be coming home until July. But even so, however, preparations are being made for the departure of Burbank, Shkaplerov, and Ivanishin. Reboost using the Zvezda service module thrusters. It's planned for 4:12 a.m. Central Time tomorrow to get the station in a good position for that undocking and a number of other activities, including the arrival of the next Progress and the three crew members that will take Burbank, Shkaplerov, and Ivanishin's place. In space today, the work is focusing on maintenance and experiments. Flight Engineer Don Pettit is working on two experiments, the BCAT-6, or Binary Colloidal Alloy Test No. 6 experiment, which looks at how liquids and gases separate without gravity's interference and how that separation forms structures. And he's working also with the Capillary Flow Experiment 2, which studies how gravity affects the movement of liquids in space. Commander Dan Burbank, meanwhile, is focused today on an upgrade of some of the station's computers. That upgrade involves the installation of several new processors called Enhanced Processor and Integrated Communications, or EPIC version. You can see some of what he's working on here. Flight Engineer Andrei Kuipers is also working with station computers today, and on the Russian side of the station, Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin are unpacking Progress 46, which arrived at the station on January 27th, carrying just under 3 tons of food, fuel, and equipment, including 2,778 pounds of spare parts and experiment hardware. That's what's going on in space today, and this is Mission Control Houston.